Cookies and milk. It's probably wired into us since we were kids. Well, my inner child just got...
Okay, now as a fellow high schooler, honestly, I gotta say one thing and one thing only. I understand how horny you guys get, okay? Like, I get it. I was once in high school too, okay? I'm only 20, okay? I'm 20 years old, okay? I understand it. But there's always a time and a place to do these things. And I didn't know that when I was in high school, and that's why I have a bunch of stories of me doing the devil's tango. But obviously, apparently, for some of you guys keep doing it, and it came to the point where I guess it's creepy to every other student. I don't know, let's just say this story gets really weird, so just stick along and just prepare for the ride, okay? Yo, what is going on, you guys? My name is Bubba, and welcome back to another crazy story. So obviously, if you guys don't know, a lot of you guys enjoy the stories with me saying the word devil's tango. And, of course, you know, I'm here to deliver. That's my job as a content creator, so let's get straight into this one. So, sadly, once again, though, I should mention, this story isn't about me. I have a really cool story about me coming up soon, but this one's about another person. But I'm in the situation. Same thing as last time, so, yeah, kind of weird. Anyways, let's start this off. So, obviously, if you guys don't know, the story starts off in high school. High school is, like, a normal place for me to do everything, or for other people to do everything. High school is, like, our haven of, like, learning your inner depths of your hormones. Hormones? Yeah, sure. We're gonna go with hormones. Now, in high school, I remember I had this math class that I absolutely hated. And honestly, I would make any excuse just to get out of that classroom. And I think all of us kind of have like a same experience with like a certain class that we dislike. But anyways, I remember there was an assignment that I didn't do. And I had to hand in, but I didn't finish it whatsoever. But before my math teacher started walking around picking up the assignments, the first thing I obviously did was walk up to her and say, "Hey, yeah, my stomach's kind of hurting. I've been having stomach pains for like the last couple of weeks. Can I go to the bathroom?" And obviously she said yes, because, you know, she's not going to say no. But the way she said it was really weird. She was like, "Yeah, just make it quick." Now, I'm going to be honest here, okay? And this is me being brutally honest. If I actually had stomach pain, okay, it's not going to be quick. So you saying make it quick is like me saying, "Oh, you're going to go puke? Okay, just make it quick." Like, sorry, I can't just, you know, push in my stomach and make sure it all comes out like in an instant second. Like, who do you think I am? But anyways, I went straight to the bathroom, obviously. I walked down to the hallway, went straight to the bathroom. And when I got there, you know, I literally like paced around the bathroom for a bit. Actually, I literally remember me doing that. It was kind of funny. I looked myself in the mirror thinking, not bad. And then I went to the bathroom stall and sat down and watched some YouTube. Now, I'm not weird for watching YouTube in the bathroom stall. I think all of us have done it before. Like, watch videos on the toilet. It's a normal thing for all of us. Like, when your favorite YouTuber uploads, like me, for example, if I'm your favorite YouTuber, comment that down below. You're kind of hot for that. No, but seriously, like, who doesn't watch YouTube on the toilet? Like, I think all of us have done it before. I know I have. So I was sitting there watching my daily Jacksepticeye. I saw a chick just walk into the bathroom. Now, if you guys are wondering how I saw her when I was in the bathroom stall, you guys obviously know there's like cracks in like every bathroom stall that you can kind of like see through. It's kind of weird because those are made for privacy, but you can still kind of see through them. It's kind of weird. I don't know. But basically, I remember looking through the cracks after I heard someone walk in, and I saw it was a girl. And I knew this chick too. Like, this chick literally had like a boyfriend and everything. And, you know, I was so curious of why she was in there. At first, I was thinking like, oh, you know, it's a mistake. She didn't mean to walk into here. But then after that, I saw her boyfriend run in there right after, and they just started making out, like, right in the bathroom. They were making out heavily. Like, they made it seem like 365 was, like a kid's movie. Like, it was so weird how hardcore they were making out. Like, they were eating each other. They were literally eating each other. So, at that moment when they were, like, eating each other, I was just kind of sitting there. I turned down the volume of my Jacksepticeye video that I was watching, because I was just really weirded out. And I was just thinking, okay, I could walk out right now, or I could, you know, wait till he's finished. Like, I don't know what to do. But then they went into the stall right next to mine, and instantly, at that moment, I'm like, okay, yeah, it's going down. He's doing the devil's tango. And I felt so weird. Like, I literally was freaking out. I was kind of panicking. Well, not like really panicking in the sense of, oh my goodness, they're literally doing the devil's tango right next to my stall. Oh my god. Like, no, I was like freaking out, like, okay, how the heck am I gonna get out of this situation? And as I was thinking of a plan to get out, I remember I instantly heard a thud on the ground. And as I look over to the stall right next to me, I'm like, what the heck was that? And then I look down, and obviously, somehow, I saw this girl on her damn knees. Okay, now obviously, I think we all know what's going down at that moment. I don't have to paint a picture. So yeah, obviously, that was going down. It was really weird. I was just really awkwarded out, and I was just thinking of a way to get out. Now, I know many of you guys are like, oh, you could have just walked right out of there. This guy was literally like a senior in our school, and me, I was a freshman, so it was awkward enough as it was. So one thing I remember doing was, you know, getting ready to leave. I remember I wiped myself and I was like, okay, I'm just gonna run out of here. 3, 2. And right as I say 2, someone else walks into the bathroom. Now, sadly, it wasn't a teacher, because if it was a teacher, that's when I knew, like, this was gonna be the funniest thing in the world. But instead, it was a kid from the leadership club in our high school. Now, if you guys don't know, I think all of us have, like, a leadership club in our high schools. Like, you know, where basically it's, like, this group of kids that work, like, under the teacher's pets. Like, I don't know, I call them, like, the ultra teacher's pets. Or, in other words, wonder pets. Losers, just kidding, I was kind of a loser, too. So, yeah, anyways, he walked in, and he instantly saw what was going on. He saw me in the stall, and then he saw them in a stall right next to me. And then this guy decides to, like, literally start yelling, like, "Oh my goodness, no way, these guys are doing it in the bathroom." And as he was yelling that, the guy runs out, pulls up his pants, and then these guys just start scrapping. Like, these guys are hardcore fighting. And then instantly me just sitting there, I'm like, do I get out of here? Do I wait? Like, I'm just watching a kid get beat up right in front of me. Because this guy, I guess, cock-blocked the guy. Like, I don't know. It was weird. And as I was just sitting there, the guys were just fighting it out. And in me, I wanted to get out of there. Like, I was like, that's it. Like, I'm leaving. I'm done. Like, I went on my belly, and I went under the stall to get out. But then as I was sliding under the stall and leaving, I instantly see a half-naked chick in front of me. I see a guy with his pants, like, semi-down-ish, fighting another guy with fully closed and, like, looks like he was getting beat up. And then there's just me on my belly, just laying on the bathroom floor that just slid out of a bathroom stall the whole time, just hearing them do the entire thing. Yeah, it was a weird situation. But then as I was on the ground, instantly, of course, as usual, another person walked in. And yes, this time it was the teacher. But it wasn't no ordinary teacher. This was our vice principal. The amazing, I'm just kidding, I hated her. No, she was a terrible person. And she decides to walk in and say, "What the heck is going on in here?" Now at that moment, I knew I was screwed. I was in deep trouble. You know, like, she came in and she told all of us to go up against the wall. And she's like, "Okay, what's going on here?" The girl instantly said, like, "Oh, I walked into the wrong bathroom." And then I remember me and the guy from the leadership club just looks at her and, like, "You went to the wrong bathroom. You're half naked in this bathroom. What?" And then obviously the guy was like, "These guys walked in and started fighting me." And then me, I'm just, like, there just, like, I was laying on my belly. I went to the bathroom. And at that point, like, the teacher was, like, so confused what was going on. So she took all of us to her office. And at one at a time, she made us all walk into the bathroom and basically say what happened. And I basically just told her, like, I was in math class, my stomach was hurting, I walked into the bathroom, I took a fat one. I didn't say that specifically, but you know what I mean. And, like, my stomach was hurting, and I heard these two people walk in, and they were just, you know, making noises. I wasn't sure what was going on. And then when I got out of the bathroom stall, I saw them fighting, and I was scared. I don't know, I made it sound like I was super innocent at that point. I don't know, I made it seem like I didn't know they were doing the devil's tango. Because, like I said before in all my videos, snitches get stitches. And, yeah, apparently, like, the girl story and the guy story didn't add up. But me and the leadership kid story kind of did. So, I guess, you know, they automatically got suspended for a week. But as for me, I remember my parents had to come pick me up after school. And when after school came, my parents picked me up because I was sitting in the office all day. Because my teacher just wanted me to make sure, like, I was safe and stuff. She was, like, going over everything with me and telling me how, like, you know, if anything suspicious happens in the bathroom, like, just please come tell me and stuff like that. As if I was going to snitch or something. I don't know. This teacher was weird. I never liked her. And, yeah, that's basically it when it comes to my experiences with bathrooms and doing it in the bathroom. Like, I've done it in the bathroom before, I'm not gonna lie. And if you guys really want to hear about me doing it in the bathroom, just press that like button down below. I'll tell you guys a bit about it if you guys want me to hear about it. But anyways, guys, that's basically it for the video. So make sure you guys leave a like and subscribe. Honestly, guys, make sure you guys follow me on Twitch and all the platforms. Seriously. And like I always say, follow for more embarrassing stories.
Yes, leave a comment, voice, Twitter, chat, and then tell me why.